Friends, today we are going to discuss the 11th topic from our EVS textbook. The name of this lesson is Force, Work and Energy. So in this topic, we are going to discuss all the three terms, force, work and energy. So in our surrounding, we have living things as well as non-living things. Living things like animals, human beings, they can make their own movements, right? They can move on their own. But plants, they can't shift themselves altogether, but they can make some movements like the moving of the branches, moving of the leaves, also the blooming of flowers. All these are the movements that are made by the plants. So this was about the living things. But there are various non-living things in our surrounding, like table, chair, then we have board, we can say chalk, pencil, pen, all these are the non-living things. Have you ever heard or have you ever seen the non-living things make movements on themselves? When we hold them, when we make them move, they surely make some movements. But have you ever seen any non-living thing making any movement on themselves or for themselves? No, because they are not having that ability to make any movement. But these non-living things, they move with our help. What is done when we hold the pen and we write with it, some movement of that pen occurs. So the pen moves, the pencil moves, right? The table, it moves from one place to other. When we carry it, when we hold it and take it to some other place. So what we do, we apply force on it. So we apply some force on these non-living things, on these objects, so that some movement is seen in them, right? When you hold a pencil in your hand and you draw lines, you draw some picture, you draw some figure, the movement of that pencil is done. But this pencil makes the movement only when we apply some force on it. But what is this force actually? So here you can see the definition for force. What is the definition for force? A push or pull applied on an object is called as force. So the definition for force is a push or pull applied on any object. It is called as the force. Suppose you want to drive away the object far away from you. So what you do? You push it. Suppose you want that object to come near to you. So what you will do? You will pull it. Right? So this push and pull, this is that is applied on the object, that is called as the force. So when we apply force on these objects, some things happen. So what are these things? These are called as the effects of force. So when we apply force on any objects, what are the effects of that force? Now let us see the effects. So the effects of force are the object can move. Suppose a pencil is kept on the table. It can't move on its own. But if you pull it towards yourself, it will make some movement. Or you push it away from you, it will make some movement. Also, so the movement of the object can be seen when a force is applied. The second is object can stop. Suppose you are driving your cycle and immediately some stone comes in between, or immediately some small child or some other object comes before you. What will you do? You will apply the brakes. That is, you will apply some force. And so what will happen? The cycle will stop at that place itself. So the force that was applied made the cycle or made that object to stop there itself. Okay. The next is direction of the object can be changed. So when you apply force, the direction of that, when you apply force on any object, the direction of that object can be changed. Suppose you are playing cricket. So someone has thrown ball towards you. And when you apply force and hit that ball with the help of the bat, the direction of that ball will change. So the force, what does it do? It changes the direction of that ball. This shows that the force changes the direction of any object. Same is with the other game. Suppose you are playing badminton. So you play with the racket and the shuttle. So when your opponent throws the shuttle, what you do with the help of the racket, you hit it. So you change the direction of that shuttle. It was coming towards you, but since you hit it with force, what happened? The shuttle is going back again to your opponent. So the direction of that shuttle changes when force is applied on that shuttle. The next is shape of the object can be changed. Okay, now when you apply force on some balloon, suppose you have a round balloon in your hand, and if you squeeze it or if you push it from both sides, what will happen? The shape of that balloon will change. It means that the force also can change the shape of some object. The next is object can be slowed down. So suppose you are playing with a ball or you are playing with anything, right? You are playing with a car. Let's take an example. So you have pulled it and you have sent the small toy car. It is moving, and if some object obstructs it, it comes in between, what will happen? The speed of that object will slow down, right? If the object is not heavy, the speed, it will just touch that object obstruction and it will move slowly next. If the object is very, very heavy, then it will come to a stop there. But if it is not heavy, then it will just push it, but the speed of that car will get less. It will get slower. Okay, the next is speed of the object can be increased also. Yes, when some greater force is applied, some pushing force is applied, the speed of that car can also increase. But if some pulling force is applied, the speed of that object will decrease. Suppose you are playing on a swing. So what will happen? If I push the swing, the speed of the swing will increase. But if I pull it towards me, will it increase? No, it will come to a decrease. The speed of the object, the speed of the swing can increase or decrease as per the force. If the force is slower, it is up. The force, I pull it towards me, it will get slower, decrease. The force is less and the speed of the swing will decrease. But if I push it with great force, what will happen? The swing will increase its speed and it will move with greater speed. So these were the effects of force on any object. So students, now let us move on to the next point, next subtopic of this lesson, that is types of force. So we learned that a push or pull which is applied on any object is called as force. So now let us see what are the types of force. So there are two types of force. The first is gravitational force and the second is force of friction. So what is this gravitational force? First, I will tell you what is the definition for gravitational force. The force by which the earth pulls the objects towards it is called as the gravitational force. We also call it as gravity. So what is the definition? The force with which the earth pulls the objects towards it. So the force applied by the earth to pull the objects towards itself, towards the earth, that is called as gravitational force or gravity. So when you play in the playground, you throw the ball upwards. Does the ball move up into the sky or it comes back to you? Yes, it comes back to you. Because it is the gravitational force. It is the force which is applied by the earth so that the object comes towards you. Right? So you throw any object. It does not move into the sky. It does not go upwards. But it comes back to the earth. Right? If you spill some water. Suppose you take some water in your palm and you spill it. You throw it upwards. The water, it will not move into the sky. But after some height, it will come back to the earth. It is because the earth pulls the objects towards itself with the help of force, with the help of some energy, that is the gravitational force. This is also known as gravity. Right? Now see the next type of force, that is force of friction. So the definition for force of friction is A force that tries to stop a moving object is called force of friction. So the force that is applied to stop the to decrease the speed of any moving object is called as force of friction. So suppose you are at your home and you want to move your chair. So you are pushing it. If the surface is smooth, you can easily push the chair. But if the surface is not soft, it is some kind of rough surface, then you will have trouble in pushing the chair or the table or any furniture that you want to push. So now I will show you from your textbook some pictures with the help of which I can easily explain you what is this force of friction actually about. So students, here you can see the gravitational force. When the ball is thrown upwards, after some distance it comes back to the ground. This is because of the gravitational force. It is because of the force that was applied by the earth on this object, that is the ball. Here you can see the ball is just thrown on the floor. So this ball has a friction. It comes in contact with the surface, and because of that friction, what happens? The speed of the ball decreases, and finally at a time it will stop. So when the speed is totally zero, the ball will stop. Also here you can see a rough surface, it causes more friction, and so it becomes difficult for us to push the cupboard. And a smooth surface, it causes less friction. So it is easy for us to push the cupboard or the table or the chair or any furniture on a smooth surface. So students, in general what happens? Smooth surfaces like glass or ice, they cause less friction, and because of this the movement becomes easy. While rough surfaces like the carpet, they produce more friction. Even if the surface it is not smooth, what happens? It is rough, then more friction is generated. So in our daily life we come across this friction many a times. So in absence of friction we can't do any activities. So friction is very very essential or important in our life. So what happens when you are writing on a rough surface? It is easier to write than on a smooth surface. So when you are writing on a smooth surface, what happens? Your hand will slip and you will not be able to increase the speed of your writing. But suppose you are writing on a rough surface, then the writing will become easier because more of friction is found there. Okay, so also when you are walking on a smooth surface, you will slip. Suppose you are walking on the tiles, the new tiles are put in the house and you are walking on it, what will happen? There is a chance that you slip on it. But if the surface is somewhat rough, then it becomes easier for walking. So this was about the force of friction.